When we go to write formulas in upper mathematics, especially in science, these animals called complex fractions, fractions within fractions, are going to crop up. And we're required to simplify them. You're not really allowed to have a fraction in a fraction. So, I'm going to give you one way that'll work all the time. And that way is going to involve our old buddy,
LCD math.
Of course, you'll have to know how to find a least common denominator. And that's going to involve... Okay? But once we've found the least common denominator, let's just go over in this video what we do with the least common denominator to simplify complex fractions. Here's an example.
Yoink!
Is this hard enough for you? Fractions within a fraction.
Ay, caramba!
What are we going to do? Well, before we try to simplify this...
There's something I have to ask you.
You've got to know what is the least common denominator of every fraction involved in this complex fraction. So basically, I hope you appreciate you're only looking at bottoms. Now, what is the least common denominator of all these fractions?
Well, ooh-la-dee-da.
It's 6. Now, what is the trick? What are we going to do with 6?
Prepare to be astonished.
I call this the LCD over 1 trick. We're going to take 6 and form it into the number 1. How are we going to do that? Well, remember, recall that the number 1, you can multiply anything by 1. 1 in a fancy form.
I know that, dude.
Remember, anything over itself is 1. 6 over 6 is 1, isn't it? LCD over 1 over LCD over 1 is 1. Anything over itself.
What a dumb thing to do. I bet you wouldn't have done anything like this.
Wait a minute. I'll show you. I'm going to multiply everybody by the LCD over 1. Everybody in the top and everybody in the bottom. In effect, I'm multiplying the whole fraction by the number 1.
Play it for her, play it for me.
Of course, I have to do it to everybody.
Play it for me. Play it for me.
Have to do it to everybody, or you're not multiplying by 1. Everybody in the top and everybody in the bottom. Now, what was the LCD in this case?
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
The LCD was...
LCD, man.
6.
Play it for me. Play it for me. Play it for me.
Okay, let's see what happens here. What did that buy me? Well, let's do one operation at a time. In this group, 6 divided by 2... Well, I'm not going to have a bottom anymore, am I?
Come on now!
No fraction. Look, Mom, no fraction. Once again, since it's the LCD, it's going to cancel out all the bottoms. Now, in this case, I have to multiply 2 times the 5. Still don't have a fraction. 6 cancels the 3. And 2 times 2 is 4. And in this case, the 6s cancel. Still get a 1. And we still multiply.
Come on down.
And my final answer, simplified, it's not that bad if you use the LCD over 1 trick. Notice we've removed the fractions from the fraction. We've simplified this complex fraction. Okay, let me show you another. This one is going to be a little bit more algebraic, if you would. Have more letters.
There's something I have to ask you.
But same thing, we're going to have to ask you, what is the least common denominator of all the fractions? This one's not that hard. Don't let it make you nervous. Only look at bottoms. The least common denominator is XY. Okay, those are the only bottoms. So we'll multiply by 1. In the form LCD over 1 over LCD over 1. Notice that I'm doing it over 1 to emphasize that the LCD is in the top, and the top kills bottoms, doesn't it? Okay, let's do it.
LCD, man.
played it for her, he played it for me.
Gotta do it for everybody.
Play it for me.
Everybody or nobody. Now let's see, one operation at a time. We get 5xy, right? No fraction. In this case, the x is canceled, that y is still there. And I get just a y, no fraction. And here the y cancels, and I get an x. And son of a gun, remember what my goal was to get rid of the fractions in this complex fraction.
No problemo.
And I've done it.
The important thing is it your final answer?
Now, can you cancel things that are added in a fraction? You have to know when to do things, but you also have to know when to not do things. Never cancel added terms in a fraction. Canceling is dividing, and you can't undo addition with division. So you have to know when to stop also. That's a very common mistake.
Direction unclear. Please repeat request.
Okay, let's do another. They're starting to look a little bit more difficult, aren't they? But they're all done the same way. I give you one way that works all the time. And how do we begin?
There's something I have to ask you.
Look at all the bottoms and decide what is the least common denominator of all these fractions. In this case, it's going to be 28x. And LCD is a superhero.
LCD.
Because he's going to save you. Of course, if I do it here.
Play it for her, play it for me. Play it for me.
Got to do it everywhere.
Play it for me.
And apparently, if I do it to everybody and it's really the LCD, my next step will have no fractions. Let's see. That's going to cancel, and 28x divided by 7 is 4x. Now I have to multiply the 4x times x minus 9, both of them, and I'll get 4x squared minus 36x. And here the x will cancel, and I'll get a 28 times 1, or 28. In this case, the 28 and the 4 will cancel, and I'm left with 7x times 1, and I get 7x. And in this case, I get a 7 multiplied by the other 7, and I get 49. Now,
is that your final answer?
I might have more to do here, but I don't know unless I factor. If I factor the top and factor the bottom, in this case, I get, and I look at the top and I look at the bottom, and nothing can cancel.
He's dead, Jeff.
So there's nothing to do.
Elvis has left the building.
So that is my final answer. But I didn't know it was my final answer till I factored. So you'll always have to try to factor because there may be some canceling. Okay? Well, that's about as hard as we'll give you.
Be gone before somebody bumps the house on you.
So go do your homework.